Hello, good morning. Today we are going to start our online classes. The spirit is meant for mathematics. Hope you're all right and getting ready for today's class. Let's think about the relations that we have learned yesterday. We have learned 6 different relations yesterday. If you just go through once again, integral 1 divided by x square minus a square dx, it becomes 1 upon 2a log x minus a divided by x plus a. Second one, integral 1 divided by a square minus x square dx, it becomes 1 divided by 2a times log a plus x divided by a minus x. Similarly, the third one that we have with us, 1 divided by a square plus x square dx is equal to 1 upon a times tangent inverse x divided by a. The fourth one was integral 1 divided by square root of a square minus x square dx is equal to sine inverse x by a. And the last one will be a single set containing 2 items, number 5 and number 6. You can see that in the denominator there is a radical sign, so it becomes 1 divided by square root of x square minus a square dx and 1 divided by square root of a square plus x square. The corresponding values have been given there. It becomes log x plus square root of x square minus a square and log x plus square root of a square plus x square respectively. So before going to the next session of the questions, you need to go through these equations correctly. Write it down separately in your notebook and be ready with these equations. In all these cases, you can see that the numerator is unity, 1 divided by, 1 divided by in each case, starting from 1 up to 6. Whereas there are certain cases in which the numerator may not be always unity. It becomes different values. For example, we have given a note on the right hand side. Just go through it once more. In case of integral px plus q divided by ax square plus bx plus dx, there you can see the numerator is px plus q and the denominator is ax square plus bx plus c. There's a slight change between the first set and this equation. The change is that the numerator is not unity. It is another polynomial, px plus q. So in this case, what should we do? The information has been given just below. The numerator should be written as, which means the numerator is px plus q. That should be written as a times, a is an unknown number, a times the derivative of the denominator plus b. So this is the way normally we respond if the numerator is a polynomial. The numerator is px plus q and that is given as a times the derivative of the denominator plus b. So this equation we write it as once again in a symbolical form, px plus q is equal to a times d by dx of a x square plus bx plus c plus b. And what is our intention? From this relation, you need to find the real values of a and b. Then after getting these values of a and b, we directly put these values of a and b and we just simplify as given below. Here is an example to illustrate the concept. The concept is like that, you are asked to integrate a relation x plus 3 divided by x square plus 4x plus 6 dx. And for that purpose, we are going to have a change. What change? We take it as x plus 3 is equal to a times 2x plus 4 plus b. So this is the way we will writing just above. The numerator is written as a times the derivative of the denominator plus b. There you can see that x plus 3 is the numerator. This is equal to a times the derivative of the denominator becomes 2x plus 4 plus b. And keep in the brain that a and b are unknown right now. You need to find the real values of a and b. For this purpose, what we do? You can give any values of x. You can give 1, 2, 3, 4, any numbers now. For a sake of convenience, we take x is equal to 0 right now. When x is equal to 0, your relation right now becomes 0 plus 3, that is 3 is equal to a times 4 plus b implies 4a plus b is equal to 3. One equation is ready for us. Now, we are going to give another value for x. X is equal to 1. So this relation now becomes a is equal to a times 6 plus b. Another way, 6a plus b is equal to 4. So we have framed a pair of relations in a and b. The first equation is a 4a plus b is equal to 3. The second is 6a plus b is equal to 4. Now on solving, we need to solve these two relations to get a and b. When you solve them simultaneously, you will get a is equal to 1 upon 2 and b is equal to 1. After getting these values of a and b, rewrite this relation. X plus 3 is equal to 1 upon 2 times 2x plus 4 plus 1. But we do, instead of a and b, give the values. Half times 2x plus 4 plus 1. So you are not supposed to simplify on the right hand side. If you simplify on the right hand side, that x plus 3 is equal to x plus 3, there is no progress. So keep the right hand side as a half times 2x plus 4 plus 1. So now let's see what is our relation. Instead of x plus 3, you can find half times 2x plus 4 plus 1 divided by the denominator remaining same, x square plus 4x plus 6 dx. Now the next line, what we do now, we are going to separate. Which one we are going to separate? The numerator will be separated into two sections. First could be half times 2x plus 4 divided by x square plus 4x plus 6 dx plus 1 divided by x square plus 4x plus 6 dx. The first one, when you look at carefully, half is a constant, you can take it outside. So half times integral of 2x plus 4 divided by x square plus 4x plus 6. On integrating, you can see if you keep x square plus 4x plus 6 as u, that is integrable, or easy method, the numerator 2x plus 4 is the direct derivative of the denominator. So for an easy way, you can put it as half times log of the denominator, log of x square plus 4x plus 6. Whereas the second one, when you go for, that becomes integral 1 divided by x square plus 4x plus 6. That you need to integrate using your first part, converting or completing in a perfect square. So that becomes 1 divided by x square plus 4x plus 6 becomes 1 divided by x square plus 4x plus 4 plus 2. Then on writing, 1 divided by x plus to the whole square plus of root to the whole square. On integrating that becomes 1 upon 2 root 2 times tangent inverse of
x plus 2 divided by root 2 plus c. Now combiningly we are getting as the answer half times log of x square plus 4x plus 6 plus 1 upon root 2 times tangent inverse of x plus 2 divided by root 2 plus c. So this is a module, this is a way we normally just simplify whenever the numerator is not unity, not one, and this is a way we normally perform. So think and revise this stuff once again. We are getting ready to do a few more questions right now.